We're back once again beside the St. Lawrence River here in Montreal for the Canadian Grand Prix. The event first moved to a variant of this track back in 1978. It was won by none other than Gilles Villeneuve, the first Canadian to ever win his home race, and in whose honour the circuit would be renamed. If you want flat-out racing, you've come to the right place this weekend, as it's full throttle for 59% of this 2.7-mile circuit, peaking at around 210 miles per hour going into the final chicane. But that speed requires discipline, and there are more than a few close walls here just waiting to punish drivers with a heavy right foot. Anthony Davidson, thanks for joining me once again for the Grand Prix. Let's talk about Brown. As with all the drivers at this level, they have a lot of ambition, but Formula One's a daunting step up from any other series, so expectations are high right from the start.
That's right, it is a difficult environment to come into. In junior categories, you're competing against drivers with similar levels of experience, but some of these guys in Formula One have been there for over a decade. But I have to say, in this case, it's so far so good.
Let's run you through the driver grid order for today's exciting race. Brown lines up on pole position, and Lewis Hamilton completes the front row. As we continue through the rest of the grid today, we have Grosjean, Vettel, Alexander Albon, and Verstappen, Ricciardo, Butler, Russell, and Daniil Kvyat, Giovinazzi, Kubica, Kevin Magnussen, and Norris, Weber, Sainz, Sergio Perez, and Kimi Raikkonen, Bottas, and Charles Leclerc completes today's grid order. And with preparations almost complete, let's head down to the track.
Okay, remember to protect the inside on the run down to turn one. Make yourself as wide as possible, robust but fair. Let's focus now for the rest of the race. police officials have enabled DRS. DRS is now available.
Thank you.
this lap, please. Stops. Daniel's in the pits. Gap ahead is 2.9 seconds. Magnussen is ahead of you. They're on old mediums. Their tyres are 9 laps old. We think they've got one more stop. The time last lap was a 1:17.1. Weber is behind you. Our gap behind is 3.6 seconds. They're on old mediums. Their tyres are 9 laps old. We think they've got one more stop. The time last lap was a 1:16.9. They're on fresh mediums. Their tyres are three laps old. The time last lap was a 1:15.2. We're dropping back by a second per lap. Gap to car in front is 4.4 seconds. Five laps of fuel remaining. Gap to the car ahead is 5.5 seconds. Behind, the gap to the car behind is 6.0 seconds. They're on fresh mediums. Their tyres are five laps old. The time last lap was a 1:16.3. We'll be right back. laps of fuel remaining. Our gap to the car in front is 5.7 seconds. They're on old mediums. Albon is behind you. The gap behind us is 7.0 seconds. They're on old mediums. Our gap to first place is 15.1 seconds. Look after these tyres now. We want to finish the race on this compound. Gap ahead is 5.9 seconds. This is your final lap of the race. Thank you for all your hard work out there. That was a strong drive and a good finish. Well done.
Yet another historic win under their belts. Well done to the team at Mercedes. Anthony Davidson, what helped them deliver this result, do you think?
Well, I honestly feel it was down to the driver and car today. I mean, we can talk driver skill all day, but if you don't have a solid team to back that, you're never going to get anywhere. When you hit that sweet spot of having both an excellent driver and an incredible car, that's when you see results like those we witnessed today.
Mercedes are on top form once again after an excellent race weekend. It's great to see them up on that podium once again. And after this round of the World Championship, Here's how things look in the driver's table. Lewis Hamilton takes over the lead of the Drivers' Championship after an excellent result. Now, let's discuss, Ant. Who would you say is a contender for Driver of the Day?
Well, my Driver of the Day has to be Charles Leclerc. He was unstoppable out on the track today, weaving through the competition with ease.
It's time to check out the constructors' standings. Mercedes continue to extend their lead. Meanwhile, Toro Rosso's strong weekend allows them to continue their march up the table. Well, that was certainly an incredible weekend of racing. Be sure to join myself and Ant for more exciting Formula One action soon.